Happy Monday. It's your boy Jumpman Jones. You're not live inside episode 233. You're now live inside episode 233 to keep the shit
live. A lot of hours
of my life.
Yeah.
On this mic.
Just know you can go back and check them out. you can go back and relive it.
Joining me today, back in the building is D behind the cameras. What's going on back there?
What's up?
Try to replace you, but we couldn't.
Never.
That's true.
No one tried to replace you.
I had to threaten somebody real quick.
I had your back.
Oh, was it like that?
None of these niggas had your back.
I missed all that.
I'm joking.
The way Johnny was cheesing the whole podcast.
Oh, wow, Johnny.
Yeah, she said I had good skin. I was like, all right.
This nigga horrible.
Sounds good to me.
That nigga like compliments.
You get one compliment from somebody different and you cheesing? That's crazy.
He was like, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you know, let me tell you.
You are a beautiful soul.
Let me tell you what I usually do when I wake up.
Yo, Johnny gave me the ill ass line this week. I ain't going to tell it on the mic. It stays between us.
Oh, okay.
He gave me the ill ass line. That
it doesn't work. I'm used to
it. No, it worked.
Oh, okay,
no,
okay.
What, pickup line?
It was a compliment. It's not a pickup line, it's a compliment.
Girl, you got a beautiful helmet toe right there. How your shit cross? I ain't never seen no shit like that.
As you can hear, too, my bright man is the funny, is the talented. It's young Picasso, your boy Jails, a.k.a. Jelly, put me on the bread. Comedian James, the jellyfish, man. What's going
on,
brother?
What's good with y'all? How y'all doing?
It's your motherfucking super. He is in the building.
Yeah,
fire.
Man. Got my shacket on.
You fired.
Shacket. Now, what two words are
was
you missing
Goodwill?
Here?
Is
it brand new or Goodwill? That's
damn,
all I'm
brother. It's brand new. Damn. I look like I shop out of Goodwill now.
She smell like a pack of Newports.
Ain't no,
I do. Smell like a pack of Newports.
I'm all thrifty over here.
No, I do like a good ass thrift store fine. Like,
but yeah, why do you call it
a shacket? It's actually H&M fine.
For
and
real?
They call it a shacket because it's a shirt and a jacket.
What?
Shacket.
Oh, so that shirt's attached to it?
Yeah, nigga.
No,
it's a shirt.
It's not. It's this.
This is
okay.
The shirt and the jacket.
Oh,
this is the shirt.
Okay.
That's
then.
Why it's like extra big and long and shit, nigga.
I like that shit.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? My shit fly a little high on, nigga.
I got something like
okay.
That.
Oh.
Yeah. All right.
All right, nigga, you have to do 6 things to get back on the podcast.
Oh, damn.
I'm not going to make you do that. All right, man, to my left is my boy, is my partner, it's my dog, it's Mr. Jukebox Johnny, a.k.a. Crown Daddy, a.k.a. Crown Poppy, or the El Himidor Poppy, the Avion Don, the Terramana God, the Milagro Ho, Mr. Steal Your Girl, and give her right the fuck back, man.
What up?
Because that beautiful hammer toe cross,
right.
Like a damn
got the polish
capital
on there. Made that little Asian lady work a little bit harder to get that toenail painted.
Girl, your hammer toe remind me of a lowercase T.
What's going on, y'all, man? Hey, listen, man, crazy. I don't know how y'all find this podcast. You listen to it every Monday on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, iHeartRadio, and SoundCloud. And we are on YouTube. If you're watching on YouTube, you subscribe, like, and comment. Other than that, shout out to everybody. Listen to episode 232 of the podcast. Those of y'all still streaming that interview, shout out to y'all. Shout out to everybody who joins us week in and week out. Johnny, you're down 3 on the fucking NFL shit, man. Hope this week really plays out.
I lost 3 games?
Damn. Nah, you just 3 behind. Now I'm like, you just 3 behind George.
Oh.
3 behind George
right
now.
Damn, George be cheap.
real quick, man. Johnny had a question.
Oh, yeah, man. It's a real important question.
Would you rather? It was a would you rather.
Would you rather? All
right. Yeah.
And it's for the fellas because I couldn't come up with an equivalent for the women.
Neither.
All right. Would you rather have in your Instagram profile, would you rather have your credit score or your dick size?
Credit score.
Damn. What if your credit score trash, though?
What if your dick size trash?
Damn,
what if both of them trash?
Oh, nah, if both of them trash, you got to do a side-by-side. Even things out, nigga.
They're going to be like, damn, your dick small. Like, bitch, that's my credit score, actually.
Also, don't put the inch beside the number. Just
you got to do a side-by-side. Maybe.
Nah, you got to put the inch on there.
I'm putting the dick size on there.
And you got to measure it in centimeters.
Because
that's exact.
There you go.
That's an exact measurement.
That's a lot of numbers.
Nah, centimeters is just an exact measurement. Like, niggas that be 6 feet may be 5'11 in centimeters.
Because I don't want nobody
six feet
hacking me when they see my credit score.
Round them out.
They gonna hack you when they see your dick size. Child. And they gonna be like, that shit too close up. So, back up. Nigga.
So you, you posting your dick size?
I posted a dick size. I ain't trying to get hacked or somebody steal my identity.
I don't want my dick size on there. It's too personal.
It is a little.
You think your credit score ain't personal?
Just putting a number up there, you get, okay, I'm 745. Okay, that's cool. I mean,
yeah,
I'm not,
you got like a 700 credit score. I mean, it's personal, but I feel like it's like, I feel
it
like.
It shows maturity.
I feel like you got your dick size on your page, you got your credit score on your page. And if your credit score like that, then it's almost like putting your dick size on your page and your dick size is 10 inches or something. Right. Shit.
Damn. So, what if your credit score up there, and I'm trying to say, but if you got the shmeet meat on there and she find out, you be like, damn, you got to stick with the shmeet.
But she
going to be bad.
She would for that credit score.
Damn, that's true. That's true.
Y'all, I like, you know.
That's a good point. If you got the right credit score, it don't matter what size your thing is.
Women are enterprising thinkers. They're like, you know what? His dick is small, but we could go far with that credit score. Come here, nigga.
That shit, you going to drop your pants. That shit going to be like, shmee.
But you going to pull that Amex out the back.
Yo. Bam. Drop that shit on the table.
Do all, all right,
now
do
come
all
get
them,
this shmeet.
Do all of them have an annual? Do all the American Expresses have an annual?
I don't even know.
I was thinking about getting one.
I don't even
just
be looking
it.
Into them.
I wasn't going to use it. I was thinking about getting one just to get it.
It'd be crazy, man.
Oh, shoot. My the bank I work for, we got a metal card now.
Oh, y'all got an Amex or just metal
card? Nah, it's just a metal card for our exclusive members. Like, you got to be rich to get one.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, you do work with rich people.
That's oh, that's what's up. I was all about right, to say, give me the discount. Let me get in there.
Not give me the discount.
Other than that, man, how y'all doing, man? How y'all week, man? Y'all good? Everybody good?
We good, man.
Yeah, yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? I mean, happy Veterans Day.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Shout out to my boy Ja.
Happy
did two tours over there.
Happy belated Veterans Day.
Shout out my boy. Let me see who else. My boy Earl went over there. Shout out to my nigga Earl.
Okay, all right.
Shit, my boy Nate went over there. Nah, I don't think Corey ever went nowhere.
Okay.
I saw people I know. Oh, my homegirl Charmaine. Shout out to her.
Shout out my cousin Tisha.
My uncles went over there because back in the day, it was either go to college or you go to the service. So shout out to all my uncles.
All my uncles.
That's all I can think of. So if I missed you, I apologize.
All right, man.
No, with the college, all
just my Uncle John, but he ain't my real Uncle John.
Oh,
but
damn.
He is my uncle because he been in my life a whole life, but he ain't never married my aunt and make her a lady. So it is what it is.
Oh, yeah, that's, yeah.
Why the man got to make the woman a lady?
That's
what
tradition.
The shit? She already a lady.
What's the new? Is that new? Is that old school to make a woman a lady? Is like
you can't do that.
You can't do that no more, right?
That's not. It's impossible.
She's a lady, right?
She been a lady
instantly.
I guess. Yeah, you're right. We changed the dynamic.
What are some old school things that people used to do that like don't exist no more? Like
chivalry.
That's one of them.
Courting.
Chivalry, dead for real.
For the most part, I mean, it's rare.
Okay. So
it is
rare. You open doors, but do you open? Are you chivalrous?
Hell no.
You not?
Nah. I mean, I'll open the door, but that's probably where I'll stop.
Okay. I think mine stopped there too.
Yeah.
I do the sidewalk thing.
Right?
I do the sidewalk thing.
Oh, you on the left side.
Yeah,
okay.
I make sure they don't get hit by a car.
I don't. Yeah. I need to get up on that.
I hold the door for a woman.
She hold me accountable every time I don't do it. Hell yeah.
Yeah, I'll hold the door. But
get
the
your ass
door
on
thing.
The outside.
And I'll open the door
what,
for
what
a woman.
What else is chivalrous, yo, besides holding the door?
The car door,
sure
I don't do that.
Car.
Opening my car door, opening my door, pumping my gas.
Light a cigarette.
Oh, yeah, you know I like
you gotta
a blunt,
light a cigarette or blunt.
My thing
light
is, blunt, if I stand on the outside, right, to protect you.
Here we
you,
go. Here we go.
I'm going to take a whole car, right? I was just saying this. Hold on, Landon. Feel me on this now.
No, stop. Where you going?
I got to take a whole car for you. You know what I'm saying? A whole car.
Okay.
How long are you going to remember me for taking this car for you?
All right.
Now, you going to put a memorial up on the sidewalk for me?
I mean, right. You assuming that you're not going to
make it. New flowers every Friday. And she got to put new flowers on every Friday.
Am I
going
to continue to be a chivalrous man in the afterlife?
All right, so
gonna be one balloon and shit gonna have no air in it no more.
What'd you say, Jay? You went down a hero, goddammit.
I got. All right, so now what are the things that the women don't do that they used to do that they don't do anymore?
Wear slips.
Wow.
My mama wears slips, nigga.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, because they wear a damn, they wear the family reunion t-shirt and leggings to bed now.
All right, what else they do that they don't do no more? Because when you said the chivalry thing, I'm trying to think.
Full course meals.
Yeah.
Hell no,
full
nigga.
Course meals. Yeah. I'm talking bread, appetizer.
Breakfast,
the bread
lunch,
is used
and
to
dinner.
Put the whole, everything on the table.
That's not happening.
She might buy you one.
Yeah, that's true. That's
she
true.
Might buy
that's
you
true.
One.
That's true.
She definitely ain't going to cook that shit. You can get the main course.
I don't know, man.
I would say being a traditional okay, housewife, you don't see many housewives like that anymore.
Nah,
in case you fucking
yeah,
rich.
I mean, they a little bit more independent. They working and stuff now.
But you
can't
remember
a housewife
used to be
a
common thing.
Yeah, it did.
That used to be common.
But you can
man,
support
we'll
a, you can support
shit.
A family off one income back in the day.
Yeah, because, I mean, shit was cheaper.
Well,
yeah.
Well, y'all grandmothers.
Two families, because they used to have a family down the street and their main family.
Well, your grandmother's housewives?
Yeah, point there.
No, my grandma had her own business. And then my other grandma, she had six kids. She didn't have no, they didn't have no daddy.
Fuck no, my grandma wasn't no housewife.
I think that's a white thing. I don't think they're too
possibly,
black.
Yeah.
My grandmother was a homemaker, but she wasn't a housewife. If that makes any sense.
Yeah,
like
that makes sense.
She still worked, but she took care of the home. Like
she still worked. Yeah, yeah.
She still washed dishes. We woke up early. She legit cleaned the floors. Do all the stuff
I
that's supposed to be
done. I think it's
safe
to say the concept of a housewife is a white thing. Black women always work because black people always work.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the most part, I think you're right, too. I'm trying to think of somebody. And I don't know anybody who grandma didn't have a job.
Now, we probably got some housewives with our generation.
Definitely. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Shout out to my grandma.
Man, they ain't nearly housewives. They starting little side hustles. They selling shit on Etsy and shit.
Because all niggas know how to do
I was
going to
say,
work.
Another thing that housewives used to do, or like women of chivalrous men back then, they would wake up earlier to look presentable.
Oh, yeah.
Before the man wakes up. Mm. So that way
wake up, shower, put their makeup on, smell
like,
good.
Stay ugly and in the bed.
And then get back in bed. So
right,
you wake up beside
they
you.
They would get back in bed.
No, stay ugly and get
oh,
in,
you
no,
would
just,
you, oh, so you get
matter of fact, sleep okay. later than me so I can roll out the bed and get alone time.
What?
Yes.
I feel you. I used to wake up early and go play the game.
Yeah. Like, you sleep shit. Later than me.
6:30 in the morning.
Well, I
mean,
back then, but
trying to be quiet.
Game,
so
the
nobody
purpose
wake
was
up.
Like to encourage him to sleep with you.
Hey, have you ever noticed when they wake up, the vibe is killed?
Yeah.
And they don't even say nothing
it's
to
like,
you.
It's like, well,
just,
there go my there, fun
there
for the day.
God damn. All right, man, let's get into the politics.
Y'all niggas about to make this a long car ride. Right? Oh, I'm saying this bullshit.
Oh, my bad.
What the fuck is wrong with y'all,
bro?
Man?
We talking about us.
I am, man.
God damn.
All right, Johnny Man Politics.
All right, man.
So that's how you be feeling?
You know them niggas be joking.
They talk about we talk about us.
Yes. All right, man. So, you know, we had the midterm elections that just passed. And it was supposed to be a red sweep, meaning the Republicans was going to take over. But it really wasn't that. They did win some seats. But it's still – the Senate's still up for grabs because there's a runoff in Georgia. So Herschel Walker did enough. He actually had more votes than Reverend Warnock.
Wow. No, but, he did?
Yeah, but in Georgia, you got to have at least 50% of the vote.
I was watching that
and
shit
he was
like
at 49.1, then Warnock was like 48.7 or
so
something like that.
So Warnock lost some point in the day Wednesday. Like
yeah,
he lost
yeah.
his lead.
Man. The last time I seen it was, I think, Thursday. Yeah, and Herschel Walker had 49.1.
Dennis and right now, dog. Herschel Walker would have won. It would have been a cold day in hell, nigga.
Right, so they got to have a runoff. So they got to run again. I think the next election in December. And that's all you vote for between them two.
Yo. Bruh, this dude, we got to stop this shit, man.
Celebrities running for president?
That's what I'm saying.
Dr.
I'm not...
Oz lost.
Yeah, true.
To well, a nigga listen. In a hoodie.
Uncle Charlotte said they just vote. Uncle Charlotte said they just vote red, bro. Like, Republicans just vote red.
I mean,
red.
Democrats
just
vote
blue,
candidate.
Too. They don't see a candidate.
But
just
that's the
red.
Thing, though. The only thing is that. Stacey Abrams kind of got beat pretty bad compared to Herschel Walker. Because the guy that beat Stacey Abrams from governor, they wrapped that up in a few hours.
Do you not think that Killer Mike endorsing Brian Kemp has something to do with that quick wrap-up? Just that one influencer from
Mike?
The black community?
I
just
don't know.
That one influencer from our
I
community?
I think maybe the fact that she a woman and people just already don't like her.
Okay.
I think maybe that could be it. Because I was trying to think about that, too. Like, why is her difference so much? Like, why did Warnock get to a runoff and Stacey Abrams got beat pretty bad?
What was her policies on gun laws?
Shit, I don't know, but I'm pretty sure that she is like throw all the guns away.
Mm. Oh yeah, you can't come down south talking about getting rid of no goddamn guns. You know
it's
we
been
live
good.
Seen episode? You seen the episode with my man Paperboy?
And then the fact that Warnock is a reverend, you can still get those Christian, those white Christians that be like, all right, Herschel Walker out here having abortions. At least this man a reverend and he got faith. So that could be it too.
Oh, with Herschel Walker?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know he was a reverend.
As no, a, the guy he running
the guy
against.
He running
yeah,
against.
Warnock is Reverend Warnock. Mm. So that could be it too. The white people, kind of like how some white people didn't want to vote for Trump because he wasn't a real Christian.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
As a black man, I need you to be in favor of me having a gun. I'm going to just say that because it's a lot of niggas trying to kill me out here.
Who?
The nigga, the police.
Oh, okay.
Did you say
nigga,
who?
Nigga, your cousin, nigga. Nigga.
I thought he knew somebody specifically.
We're going to have Negro sensitivity training with Johnny later
right,
on.
Right. Like,
nigga, it's a lot of people trying to kill you.
Atlanta, you got feral hogs want to kill you.
Yeah, feral. You might get done in by a hog, nigga. You got to have you one on you.
All right, man. So two more states decided to make marijuana legal on the recreational level, Maryland and Missouri. So shout out to Maryland and Missouri, man. So if y'all ever in the DMV, you can go to Virginia. Shit about to be legal. Maryland is about to be legal. And I think it's already legal in D.C.
Come yeah, on, North legal Carolina.
In the district.
Yeah.
Roll the dice.
We got to. If South,
loosen that Bible
you
belt.
You think South Carolina or North
CBD
Carolina going to be first?
Huh?
You think North Carolina or South Carolina going
to
be first?
North Carolina most definitely.
I don't know, but they're going to have to Purple loosen
South
the
South Carolina
notch.
Already got them fireworks, though.
Yeah, but that's like, that's redneck.
Yeah. That's like, redneck fun.
Yeah, and we got tobacco in North Carolina, so maybe.
They unloosening that belt one notch.
Yeah, because niggas tired of smoking that Delta 8.
And now if they could just let the alcohol ABC store be open on a Sunday, we lit.
Well, you can buy alcohol on Sunday now, but it got to be from a distillery.
It gotta be from a, yeah.
But
honestly, distilleries locally compared to breweries, you don't want that bullshit alcohol. I
the
mean,
only place I had.
Muddy River's good.
I had Dragon Moonshine. But, yeah.
Seven jars is good.
I do Muddy Rivers. I think I've had seven. Oh, that's moonshine. I do Muddy Rivers. That rum is good. That's some good ass rum.
Mm-mm-mm. All right, man. And also, America has its first Gen Z member of Congress. Maxwell Frost, at the tender age of 25, won the 10th district of Florida. So he's the youngest member in Congress right now.
Ain't every nigga in last name in a movie Frost? Wasn't they bad
Frost?
Possible. This nigga kind of look like nigga. The
Weeknd. I don't trust him.
That's who he look like?
Yeah. Now, here in North Carolina, Sherry Beasley, she lost to Ted Budd.
I knew she was going to lose.
Yeah, they was killing her.
Sherry?
Sherry didn't have a good damn commercial until, like, it was time to vote. How you going to have one good commercial when it's time to vote and shit? They've been slinging mud on your ass ever since they started.
All right. And then also, state lawmaker Tony DeLuca was reelected in Pennsylvania, but he died in October.
Goddamn.
So I don't know how he got reelected. His name was still on the ballot, and people voted for him.
So what happens next?
They just going to have somebody fill his position. I think the governor fills the position with someone.
Who was running against him?
That's a good question.
Like, because that's fucked up. Like, you lost to a dead dude.
You sorry.
yeah,
this nigga wasn't even out there campaigning, and you lost.
Fuck. That sucks.
Yeah, that does suck. That's like playing basketball against nobody and losing.
Facts.
Mm. That also sucks. But you got to miss every layup.
Yep, that's it for politics, man.
To the rack.
All right, man. So the lottery was this past week. There was a winner announced.
Shout out to that person.
$2.04 billion
that's
lottery winner.
That's crazy. Right. It's only one person.
They richer than Kanye.
One person. It's just one person. After taxes, are they richer than Kanye?
Well, they was in California. California tax your ass to death.
I would say they only get a like 400 something million.
God damn.
I wouldn't even give a fuck.
They take a good bit. $2.04 billion?
They took how much?
I think when they calculated it was still at the 1.9, so I don't know what it's at now.
Oh, 1.9 billion. Okay.
Right, but they still take a lot to where I feel like it may knock them back.
Probably.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
I know in North Carolina, I gotta pay taxes
on this shit every year.
Cause you gotta pay taxes
up front, but you do pay taxes if you go get assets and things and.
Nah, put that shit under your mattress.
Drastically increase your lifestyle.
Put that shit under your mattress.
Yeah, you'll pay tax, but you'll
stay in the trailer park.
So you good? That's that.
Got on the baby shirt.
Yeah, man. That's
rest in peace,
Cam.
I was looking at. I'm like, you got a belt on.
CNN put out a think piece saying how the lottery was racist. No. Wrong word. The lottery feeds into systemic racism.
Yeah, let some niggas win.
Not even that. It's because black people are low income people spend the most money in the lottery. And the lottery is supposed to go like to our schools and shit, but it doesn't. It goes to like schools like
universities.
Like UNCC would get the money, or Myers Park would get the money. Places that don't really need the money get the money.
That's a good. Now we gotta go out here and fight.
So
our
now
rights.
We feed the system.
You know what I thought about? Like, they'll set the lottery at an amount, but they not telling you how much they made.
Oh yeah,
off
facts.
Them tickets. If you think about it, nigga, everybody buying tickets, and then I think DJ Khaled bought 20,000
what an
tickets.
That's
$20,000, ain't it?
Yeah. You're rich. Why you can't hit the lottery
he
for?
He ain't $2 billion rich.
I guess not.
But that's what I'm saying.
It's like, you're right. They don't tell you how much you win. I mean, how much they
probably got about damn near a billion.
Well, see, I think the state don't make money off the Powerball or the Mega Million. I think the state make money off scratch-offs.
That's what that article's talking about.
Yeah, I think the Powerball and Mega Millions is like a national lottery.
On top of the national lottery, but the scratch-off is what they made references to.
Yeah.
People thinking like, all right, if I can hit today, I can pay off a bill. You know what I'm saying? It's little shit like that.
Yeah, for sure. Y'all heard about that nigga in Tennessee? I think he was in Tennessee. Yeah, he was in Tennessee. So apparently he told his girl's supposed to go buy everybody a lottery ticket in the house. And apparently her mama got dementia and took his ticket. So that nigga came over there raising hell, was trying to figure out where his ticket was at.
Nigga got the losing ticket, nigga.
So he kidnapped his baby mama and it just went crazy.
How you
they said he started shooting
mama.
Cause he wouldn't let her get out the car. Said he started shooting at people and people were shooting back at him. And she was like, let me out the car. And all this over a lottery ticket.
That wasn't a winner.
That wasn't even a winner. Like, bro,
are you serious?
Like, don't go crazy until you find out somebody in the house won.
Bro, that's what I'm saying. But he was hopped up off potential.
Yeah.
He could pop.
Like, nah, I put my $2 in too. Where my ticket?
That nigga thought he won already. I'm going to kill this motherfucker
right.
Over this $2 billion.
Poverty.
I mean, it did take what? It took like a week for the winner to be finally announced?
Yeah, because they said they had to verify some shit.
So I can see you being hella broke on edge.
I think it's the highest.
Not that much on edge.
Yeah, the highest
so
ever.
When they drop those numbers, they check it a few times before they announce it or before they confirm whatever came out.
Oh, yeah, they got to because...
Boy, if y'all
that should be
me.
Wrong. That ain't like the Miss America pageant. You now announced the wrong winner.
And you just changed your mind.
Yeah.
If y'all niggas ever call me and I'm in Raleigh, you know what it is.
And that's the crazy part.
What you up to, James? Just picking up my winnings.
Up here in Raleigh. What? Right. Oh, that nigga don't hit.
That's the crazy part. They make your ass drive all the way to Raleigh.
I don't
and
mind.
I really
nigga,
don't
I'll
like.
I'll be there tonight.
Boy, I'll be driving safe as hell. It's like, it'd be just the devil in me if I get. I die in a car crash on the way up to this bitch.
Oh, nah, the fuck
nigga,
that part
I'm
is you can't be anonymous.
In the slow lane, nigga. It's going to take me 5 hours to get to Raleigh that day.
It don't matter getting there. Shit is getting back. Like, you're not anonymous.
Oh, nigga, I got a beauty.
I'm going straight somewhere else.
Nigga, I ain't coming back.
I'm
what do you mean get back?
Oh, time out,
I'm in
out,
RDA, out of there.
This the perfect time to use your credit. Get you a motherfucking some security. Get you goddamn a car in front, car in back. Y'all drive up there, get the check.
What a security going to whoop your ass.
Right.
Security like, you know what? This nigga a whole lick. Damn.
Nah,
that
I
want money,
my shit direct deposited.
They work for me now.
I need a wire transfer. Now, if I win, I'm doing the 30 years or the 20 years where they give you a bit of it every year.
Hell no.
You won't take it along?
Get my shit.
Yeah, get my lump.
Because I believe you're going to try to snatch it back or something.
I kill me.
Yeah, or something. Get my shit.
Y'all niggas too street
nah.
smart.
Give me all
nah,
my shit.
I would want it up front because it didn't take nothing for be like, oh, the computer messed up. We ain't sending this year. Nah, I ain't got time.
I ain't got, yeah.
I ain't get my shit.
Me my check.
It's a glitch in the system. Yeah, right. It's a glitch in your hand, bitch. Give my money.
All right, man. While we on the subject of money, man, this famous Nigerian influencer by the name of Hush Puppy, Raymond Abbas.
What?
Nigga named Hush Puppy.
Right.
This nigga must pay back $1.7 million as a part of his sentence. He was he was caught for money laundering and sentenced to 11 years. Now, this nigga was nice with it. In 2020, he posed as a Wells Fargo banker in New York to steal money from a Qatari business person. And I think he stole about 3 or 4 million from him. I think in total he stole about 47 million. Let's see. He middlemaned a deal and laundered 4.7 million to a bank.
How much he got to pay back?
Just 1.7.
Oh, okay.
But you know, all that, but all that money gone. But that money was intended for a North Korean government deal that he laundered, that 4.7 million.
Dang.
He took
money. He stole the money from the North Koreans?
No, he middlemaned the deal, it looks like, and was able to get 4.7 million out of
for the Korean.
14.7. That money was supposed to go to North Korea.
Oh, damn. Kim Jong-un got finessed.
Oh, shit. This nigga say, yo, fuck my cash out.
Millions of pounds from a millions of pounds from a professional soccer club in the UK. About 923,000 he got wired from a law firm.
This nigga Will Smith in that movie.
I look at his Instagram, man. Like, he lived in Dubai, like, in one of the apartments that you pay monthly for with all the luxury cars parked out front. That's where he got caught at and transported back to the U.S., man.
Dang, bro. Them Nigerians. Shout out to all my West Africans. Shout out to Target for selling that Jollof rice.
What's Whoa. What's up with the Nigerians scamming like that?
Nigga, they broke. Nigga, what you mean?
50 Cent reported. I don't know if it's true, but 50 Cent. They're saying he wants to make some type of movie about a Nigerian dude.
Yeah, because they made the little Hulu series about the little white girl.
And they made they made Anna that one chick. Movie about the people that robbed Wells Fargo in Charlotte.
Let me tell you something about people that's in poverty. They ambitious, nigga.
Oh, yeah. No.
They gonna make something out of nothing.
Cancel
nigga.
That. That's you hear how we have a collective understanding of the African men, what we know about them. They might be scammers.
Yeah.
That shit you was talking before these cameras came on. No one ain't never heard of that.
Oh, well, you looked it up and it was real. But but nah, they ambitious, bro. Like, for real. You know what I'm saying?
We looked that shit up and found one article, man.
Nigga, the shit was real, nigga. Don't doubt me. Anyways.
We found one article, nigga.
It happened, though. What
and what was the article, Johnny?
It was like a woman giving an opinion.
One woman, one opinion.
I forgot that shit. I don't even know if I got it up here anymore.
Man, keep going.
Okay.
But yeah, you know what I'm saying? People of property are ambitious and they dream about certain things. You know
Facts.
What I'm saying? And they gonna try to go get it. They gonna try to go get it, and it's no different as if you're chasing your dreams.
I
you know
had
what
two
saying?
Wild dreams the other night. Speaking of,
what?
So the first one, it was all in the same night. So I don't know what I ate, what I did before, but it was crazy. Mm-hmm. The first one, I was, you remember Lupita Nyong'o from Us?
Okay, okay.
So I'm like laying on the ground. I don't know how I got to this place, but I'm laying on the ground, and she in the Us costume looking at me and
Whoa,
shit.
Oh, you done fucked up.
And I couldn't wake up.
You better.
Yeah. And then the second one, I was, you know, you ever seen that M. Night Shyamalan movie where the people get old on the island?
Oh, yeah.
They age real quick on
the
island.
I like that movie. So,
old age.
Yeah, so me, my mom, and my grandma was at these random people houses. And every time we went in the kitchen, we would come back and we would look older. And then my grandma and mom never came back from the kitchen, so I'm trying to walk around. The people that live in the house, they they won't tell me what's going on. I'm like, what the fuck wrong with the kitchen? What the fuck wrong with the kitchen? And they wouldn't talk to me. And then some little kid punched me in the butt, and I woke up. I know, wow. Shit weird, right?
You know how I be getting out of bad dreams?
What?
I pinch myself. I realize
what,
that I'm
in
going
the dream?
Through it. Yeah. I realize I'm going through a bad dream, and I goddamn pinch myself. Real
Sometimes
talk.
Sometimes you realize you're dreaming.
Real talk.
But me, I don't.
Once I realize it, I'll be like, man, fuck that shit.
Yeah.
Wake my ass up.
You know what the worst dreams are?
Time out.
It's the ones.
No.
For real.
No.
Once I realize it.
No. How are you doing that?
It's James, man. He's a special person.
I'm trying to tell you
I'm trying to tell you.
Are you
consciousness
or nah?
My consciousness is aware at all times.
So you
nigga,
a light sleeper.
Even when I'm asleep, nigga.
So you pinch yourself in real life?
No. What it is. In the dream. What it is like sometimes when you have a dream, you realize that you're dreaming. So only when I realize it, you know what I'm saying? I don't catch it every time. But when I do catch it, I'll be like, fuck that. If it's a bad dream and I know it's a bad dream,
is this in real life or in the dream?
This is real. Oh, no, this in the dream. So I feel
something. Okay. All right.
When you feel it.
I thought this nigga was ill like
that. You should have been in Inception.
Next news story. Next news story.
I probably should have.
They calling foul play on these three dead Americans found in Mexico City. They went down there to celebrate the Day of the Dead, and they were said to be dead. They were said to be dead from carbon monoxide poisoning in their Airbnb.
They ain't got no detectors down there.
That's what they're saying, but when I don't know if it's credible. I don't know if it's credible.
What, do you think somebody set them up?
It's hard to say, man, because people...
That's them?
Yeah, that's them. Three Americans found dead in an Airbnb on
black
a trip.
Folk. What the hell they going down there for Day of the Dead for?
Man, you know Candace black folk Florence, like to travel different places, man.
Jordan Marshall.
Take your ass to Cancun.
Cortez Hall.
On a resort.
We'll go somewhere dangerous as fuck just for the opportunity to go. Where they going? Oh, I heard that shit beautiful.
Yeah.
It'd be like Skull Island or something.
That's done.
Damn, man. Shout out to black folk traveling, though.
No,
that shit
crazy.
I mean, that's a bad shout out because they died. But,
yeah, yeah. You know, but they look happy in the picture.
Let's make sure they're safe.
Shout out. Also, this week, man, Meta announced, or Facebook announced, they'll be letting off 11,000 employees.
Oof.
They're cutting their workplace, they workforce down 13%.
I need to check on my cut.
And they're extending the hiring freeze through quarter one. Y'all haven't layoffs yet?
Not yet. They bet not.
You know what they replaced them with?
Computers?
Yes.
You think so?
Yes.
Hmm.
Technology is advancing.
I'm not going to lie, man. I want the computers to replace everybody at the grocery store. Like, I'm tired of them.
Hold on.
Not me.
Nah.
I love
so you. I am
go,
tired of these.
So you going to go to the grocery store.
For the first time I went tonight, and there were two older women that checked me out. They had on white shirts. They had on different uniforms.
Retired
and the young kids.
Yes.
And they were so nice to me. Like, I mean, full-fledged conversation. How you doing? Did you find everything?
I'm
I was like, yo, what, can we hire more of them?
Niggas.
No. The young kids
gone.
I'm sick of somebody with lashes. I'm sick of lashes and legs checking me out. Like,
I'm tired of these kids, bro. Like,
they
fucking suck.
And they do suck. They do suck.
Like, bro.
That's management, man.
Hey.
The management be wild.
Do the thing. Too. They need to do the thing. So
I am pretty wild. I will say.
When you went to the Amazon store in Washington, could you walk out or you had to scan out and the door open?
No. So you scan on your phone. It was a QR code to your personal account. You scan to go in. It's like the subway doors. It just opens up. You literally shop. And then you walk up to the thing, it just opens up, and you walk out.
But you got to scan to go out?
No, you don't scan to go out. You just walk out.
Oh, it just opens up for you. So,
yeah.
But it already charged you because you scanned everything while you was going.
No, you don't scan anything. You literally pick stuff up. Like, if I tested it. If you walk over and you pick up a can of soda, and then you walk around, you change your mind, you put that soda back, it takes it off. Like, you can monitor.
How is it telling what you picked up?
There
though?
Are millions of cameras literally
Damn,
in the ceiling
boy.
That are
Eagle
tracking
eye.
You.
Yeah, you niggas is almost out of a job,
Fuck.
B. When I was in the Netherlands, you go in the grocery store, the thing open up for you. You go get what you need, and then you pay the machine, and then you know what I'm saying, the door open to let you out the store. But, like, you don't have to go to a cash. Like, it's literally, like, maybe one, two cashiers in the grocery store. Like, we
don't. Or if you don't buy nothing.
Okay, so they have two people
in there. Oh, it's
going
to let you out regardless.
Oh,
yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's going to let you out regardless. But you got the U-Scan person watching the U-Scan.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay. Kind of like Walmart.
Yeah. Like, but I want the whole shit U-Scanned out. Like, fuck them cashiers.
I did go to the Dollar Tree the other day. They had self-checkout.
Oh my bad.
Nah, it was cool. I was just like, damn, Dollar Tree got self checkout now.
They should.
Please.
They always got one fucking register
one
open.
Register
it should be
open.
Down the line.
That's
and then
true.
I'm tired. Like, tired of what?
Right. And then I hate when I get in line to go see the person at the register and they're a dick. Like, I just came to you because I figured, you know, you a bag this shit. I don't feel like bagging it today.
Right.
But you a dick anyway.
I like going
I could
to the
just
lines.
Went to the machine.
I like asking people how their day was.
I mean,
yeah,
I like customer service.
You old.
What I can't stand is when they have conversations with their colleagues. Like, I'm not standing there. Yeah. Like, I legit just had to say something at some point because one girl was talking about her having sex and somebody else got an STD from the dude she was fucking.
Damn,
like,
you talking about that?
They were
at?
Having a conversation, like checking my shit. I was like, hey,
you was at Winn-Dixie.
I don't
Damn.
Care.
Damn,
you should have turned around. Damn. Tater
so
pie.
What STD did you get out of
don't
here.
Be touching
like,
my vegetables with that chlamydia hand, bitch.
is a herpes on your goddamn
touching
lip.
My bananas with them shit dirty ass STD hands, yo.
Yo. I can't stand this.
Facts, nigga.
But I was gonna say, man, we expanding our self checkout.
Oh, please. For real?
They about to knock out three please. Of our registers.
Yeah, because y'all, knock out I ain't gonna lie, Walmart
y'all
shit trash.
Y'all
yeah.
the worst.
The regular employees be trash.
Yeah, yeah, this is the worst. I will say,
unless
I got
to buy a
employees.
Pack of Newports, then I got to go in.
That's one place I won't wait in line for a cashier. Like, hell no. I did that one time last year and regret it.
No.
She was
our
the
front end employees
worst.
Are terrible. We got yeah. this one girl, she just coming there for a fashion show. I can't stand her ass. I can't stand
I used to
that.
Hate the niggas that came to work G'd up. Like, we work at Harris Teeter.
Right.
Well, you come in with the freshest J's. I know you not about to do shit.
No, no.
Fact, you yeah, not.
I know you not about to do shit. You just came in with some just drop stone, nigga. They just dropped.
Just drops.
See, I come in there with the shoes for crews. I outwork half the staff, baby.
Shit, we gonna work your
ass. I appreciate that shit. Especially the cart guys. They coming in with something that just dropped. Like, you know you about to go
and the nigga that can't get a regular job and they hooked him up because he's special. That nigga be working his ass off. Nigga be sweating and shit, smelling like must.
Hey, we do got one nigga that got a little arm. He
be
wrangling
the working hard, though.
Bruh, this nigga wrangles some buggies like you ain't never seen before. You like, how is this nigga doing this shit?
All right, Johnny. That nigga love employment, bro.
Like, Johnny,
that nigga's like, fuck a new disability story. Check, bro. I want employment.
Bro, be goddamn.
What am I on?
It.
Barbecue restaurant.
You be like, what the fuck?
Shout out to him, man.
Yeah. He a real nigga, man.
Yeah. Y'all don't want to go to work because y'all got COVID. This nigga ain't got nothing. Ain't got no hand.
I ought to be like, this nigga got one arm.
Right.
He here every day. Nah, I'm firing your ass. Get out of here. In case you got a short arm.
All right, man. So a lady, man, she went to Raleigh, North Carolina. She went to Clyde's Cooper's Barbecue. And I don't know if y'all familiar with barbecue, but when you smoke meat, it gets like this little pink ring around it. So she was eating in a rib, and she said, this meat ain't done because it had the pink in it.
These niggas selling poison meat.
That's what she said. So she asked them to give her a refund, and they was like, we can't give you a refund, but we'll give you some free whatever else you want on the menu. So they gave her the chicken, told her she could keep the ribs, and didn't give her a refund. So she called the police.
Did
and she left
the
a hell of a Yelp review.
Did she keep the chicken?
She did.
Nah, bro.
She says, worst customer service I ever had in my life.
See, we just talked
barbecue
about.
Barbecue was very pink and had lots of fat in it. Tried to go back and tell them I either want my money back or something else. They refused to do either. After I called the cops in all uppercase.
It's a white woman.
I don't know. Her name Annie Cook.
She definitely.
They gave me one piece of chicken in a bag and said, keep the plate. Cops said I had to file a civil suit with the courts. Worst food ever. Cheese not even melted on the mac and cheese.
Ew.
Ugh, that shit was just a brick.
Some noodles
that's
and
what
some
she said.
Cheese?
They said, keep the plate.
They know
some
bullshit.
Oh, my goodness.
That's crazy. That's nasty.
We got to do better.
Shout out to Clyde's Cooper's Barbecue. Oh, let me see who owned Clyde's
is
Cooper's.
Is that black on?
Yeah, let's see before we shout them out.
Because black people have never put a piece of Kraft cheese up there.
I need you talking to Mike, please.
Oh, you're right. You're right.
And they would never do that.
Let me see what the food looking like on there. I know where Clyde's at. This shit famous. She might have just been kind of weird.
I mean, they might have fell off by now.
Yeah, it's possible.
All right, man. Also, on Friday, which is it's Monday, but so they had a funeral for Takeoff. It was supposed to be no phones, but they've been dropping little, I guess, eyewitness accounts from the funeral. But I do want to say, man, rest in peace to him.
Rest
that
in peace,
shit is
Takeoff,
tragic,
man.
Very tragic.
How are we still having no phone events in 2022?
I mean, but why can't you respect the dead and just not bring your phone?
I feel what you're saying, but logically, somebody gonna bring their phone.
Oh yes, yeah, always. Even the Marvel things, and they be having
they'll say
no phones.
It is always somebody dropping
something. I know to be successful with no phones, and shout out because he is also what you call it, hosting SNL this week. Dave Chappelle. I've not ever seen, like, when he has
they got
his
phone check.
Yeah, when he has his phone checks, phone check comedy shows, I don't see anything from those. Mm. Like, it's
you
legit.
Can sometimes. It's rare. It is very rare to see glimpses of shit yeah. Dave don't want you to see glimpses of. It's very, very rare.
I think he's probably the one person that yeah, does a great job.
To see them blood
but
sacrifices.
I haven't seen any clips from Takeoff shit.
That's fucking
they say yeah. They floating around. I haven't seen
I've seen them
clips.
On Twitter
I've seen some
already.
Pictures,
yeah, I've
but
seen
professional
some.
Photos. I haven't seen like
I don't,
any cell
honestly,
phone pictures.
I don't want to see them niggas sad.
I don't want to see. I don't understand
I don't
why it's
that.
Like exclusive news that someone is breaking down. Someone is... not able to handle something like doing a speech like these are people.
I get it because
it's a funeral.
I get it because you know people on like celebrities are not human to regular people. You know what I'm saying? So you want to like seeing them cry, seeing them go through real life shit, kind of humanizes them. Right. So I get why people want to see it. Like I remember when Kobe died, I went through and watched all the basketball player interviews. I like to see them be human because a lot of times you forget they are just regular people like you and I. They just got a job and they're on TV.
Remember when Ray J lost it at Whitney Houston funeral?
I think the last one I watched
Ray
was...
Ray J was goddamn crying. Boy.
Oh, he did date her, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That nigga
I think
was hugging
the
casket
was,
and shit.
I think, yeah.
Oh,
he said
was.
He was with her.
Oh.
But...
yeah, he
was
with her the night of.
What you call it? Michael Jackson.
Hmm.
That was the last film I watched. And
oh, yeah, that was on TV. Yeah,
yeah.
That
and
was
I,
TV.
That was a lot.
Yeah, I watched. Yeah. I mean, I kind of watched Princess. I mean, not Princess, The Queen. Little bit of it. Like I was with my mama and she wanted to watch it.
Can we say those are different type of funerals?
Yeah, those are different.
Like when somebody 90 dies, just kind of like,
okay.
It's still sad. Don't get it wrong. But it's just like, it's more so like, damn, like you did that. Like 90.
Yeah, more of a celebration.
It's more
homecoming.
Like, it's more like, you know. Even when I talk to people who have older relatives that pass, they've been preparing themselves for so long for this person to pass. And when it finally happens, of course, it still hurts the same. But it's just, it's different than somebody 28 who legitimately, like, even though tomorrow's not promised, if a nigga 28, if a nigga 16, you do expect him to be here tomorrow for some, you know.
Yeah.
You expect to see him later on. You expect to see him grow up. You don't expect to wake up tomorrow and get a phone call saying, yeah, such and such died, 28 years old. Such and such dead, 16. Like, that shit is, like, what? You know what I'm saying? Even somebody 50, like what? I don't know. But rest in peace to him, man. And prayers to their family. All right, Wakanda Forever dropped too. I don't know if anybody has seen it. I know George said he's seen it already.
Shout out to George.
Me and Johnny have seen it.
I'm slipping.
It's all right, man.
Usually I go see a movie.
Yeah, man. I'm not going to spoil the movie, but it was good.
But I just want to know, do you think that the Mexicans going to start doing how the black people was doing for the Wakanda Forever? You think the Mexicans going to be doing the Mexican shit?
Okay. That's what that shit look like. All
right.
We'll see.
What's
see.
The Mexican shit?
The Namor's people would do
that.
That's what they would do when the black folk would do this. They would do that.
Were they shooting Kamehameha?
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's a little different. I don't know what Ryan Coogler was thinking when he wrote that shit.
But it was a real good movie, man. My hot take, it is better than number one to me. But this is to me. You're talking to a guy who didn't really like
it. I mean,
usually
sequels suck, so it's good. It's good.
It was a real good movie.
So Goku in this one.
Nah, that nigga Namor a bad boy.
Yeah. I don't want to talk about it, man.
I'm interested
I can't
to see
talk
what they do
it.
With the winged feet. I'm very interested
Jesus,
to see
man.
What's up with that.
Go to the movies.
Yeah, I know.
ASAP.
I want to see what's up with that.
All right, man. The Nets got a new head coach, Jacques Vaughn.
Damn, man.
Who?
Jacques Vaughn.
Oh, this nigga is an agent, nigga, from Russia. Jacques.
Nigga probably Haitian.
By the time you hear this podcast, Kyrie Irving will be back on the floor, according to James.
Yeah.
You say he back on the floor?
Yeah.
So, do y'all think he completed his six things?
Man,
his
he
six
didn't
things.
Do that
he
shit.
Did meet with Adam Silver, so maybe Adam was like, "Fuck it, bro, you straight."
So
you
everybody who
you
don't
an anti-Semitic.
Know the six things he got to do before he could play
well,
basketball.
Adam said, we did steal y'all shit. Dude.
He got to issue an apology for posting the link and condemn the content. Complete anti-hate causes. Ooh shit.
They try. Oh, go ahead. My fault.
Causes Irvin and hold on. Complete anti-hate. Oh no, he's got to donate to anti-hate causes. Irvin and the Nets have agreed upon a $500,000 donation, which I heard
he
they denied that. Sensitivity training, complete anti-Semitic, anti-hate training, designated by the Nets.
He had to do that.
Meet with representatives from the Anti-Defamation League. I'm pretty sure he did that.
Yeah.
And the Jewish community leaders in Brooklyn. And then after he does 1-5, he's got to go meet with the owners of the Nets and the lead franchise officials and demonstrate the lessons that he learned. Pretty much tell him like, "Yo, I learned my lesson."
Nigga, I give a book report.
Okay, but what the fuck?
So he didn't do the
people that created the documentary? What did they do for Bezos?
Bezos didn't create it. He just got a platform that has it.
On his platform, though, so it's like if you didn't want it to be shared, you should have not provided a copy link or something where he can share it. Like he just shared what was available.
And you can go buy the shit right now.
Exactly. That's like me just telling y'all, hey, I went to go watch Harry Potter. I got to go apologize to Christians for watching witchcraft bullshit. Like, no.
What's this Nike thing everybody talking about?
I think Nike
said something.
Nike isn't saying they dropped them, but they looks like they are going to drop Kyrie Irving from his shoe deal because of him posting the link.
I never will understand the shit.
A couple things. So
I've seen some racist shit before. That ain't it.
You watched the video? You watched it?
I ain't watching that movie.
Oh.
Now I'm just saying, like, him just doing that, I just feel like it's more like.
Well, I play devil's advocate. You're Kyrie Irving. Everybody loves you. Everybody wants to be you.
I hate Kyrie Irving.
All the kids look up to you. People look up to you. You have a following of 1 million+. If you post something, if you endorse something, then it's going to get viewed. If you endorse it, you know, so people are going to go check it out, which the movie went from being $4 to rent to $10 to rent, went from being $20 to buy to $50
to buy. That owner's making bank.
So I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that within itself is wrong. I'm just saying, like, you endorsing that caused people to go watch that. Now, do I think Jeff Bezos and his platform should be held accountable for having that shit on their platform? Yeah, but I mean, let's think about what else is on Amazon Prime.
Porn.
And we got to think about who Jeff Bezos is. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I
don't know. That's like saying YouTube has to be held accountable for all the anti-Semitic speech that's on it, because
Tariq Nasheed and Dr. Umar.
Yeah, we just because, you know, they're not gonna hold YouTube accountable. I don't think it's right. But if we're going to try to hold him accountable for just posting a link to buy something, then it should be equal play, but it's not.
Well, okay, but why not? Oh, okay, the documentary creators. Like, no one said. He didn't create it. He just shared what he saw.
You're right. And I don't know why
I agree. He shouldn't have. Having that much, you know, you are a celebrity. Certain things you just can't do.
Yeah, and I think they should go. I think they should. If you're going to punish somebody for one thing, punish everybody involved.
Right.
But, I mean, that's not what they're doing.
I just call me conspiracy brother.
Okay.
But,
hi, conspiracy brother.
Is it funny to y'all, like he said, the price increase just to watch it? So it went from $10 to $12. It went from $12 to $20.
Yay, man. It went from $20 to $50. Yesterday's price ain't today's price.
And I feel you, but why?
Because of the publicity behind
what do you mean?
It.
You're right.
Because I'm curious.
But
to
Amazon
why.
Didn't right. raise the price. You can sell on Amazon. So if
the creators of
if
that
Kyrie
movie
endorsed my
price.
Movie, and I get word and it's in the news, hey, change that price.
But right. I hate that word endorse. Reason. Endorse means it means what, support. So is he supporting the movie or is
actually,
he
just telling niggas to check it out?
Put money behind.
Has a
when
person
you're endorsing something,
has a
got
person
some money
of influence?
It.
Everything you do is an endorsement.
Endorsement, okay.
Everything you do is an endorsement.
I thought people had to have money behind it, though.
Nah, everything. Sometimes you get free endorsements.
Tell a nigga to check it out no more.
I had a homeboy. He had a clothing line. If a celebrity wore it, that's free endorsement. And he would just repost like, "Yo, such and such had my shit on." That's free endorsement. The nigga found it, liked
what?
It, wore it, and it just so happened
Wait
to
get
caught
a cricket,
on TV. Right? Free
we
endorsement.
Start our own clothing line.
Like. I see these guys. Sometimes you see these guys with shit on all the time, and they may not tag the maker. But if you can Google their shirt, or Google what they got on, and figure out how to, you know, get it. So, I mean, it's just unfortunate, man. I think
H&M. Let me get that.
I think if it was gonna end in an apology for Kyrie, then it should have started in an apology.
It should have started. Right.
Yeah, like If you was gonna be rebellious, stay rebellious.
I don't
if
like
you
how
was gonna
people
apologize,
got his back
just
now,
apologize.
Though.
I just don't like how these companies, these individuals are so loud when it comes to quitting and trying to back away from a black person. I think that's where we holler about.
Mm-hmm.
We say it's racist, and people are like, "Oh, here you go throwing in racism." Well, that's what we're talking about—the systematic approach to it. But even if they were to condemn the creators of the documentary, we'll never know. it might be one or two articles. CNN might pick it up, but it will not be as public and as loud as they're handling Kyrie. No. And that's the fucked up part. And,
yeah, and it's like that with everybody.
That's
though.
How they used to do the smart slaves. And, they would hang them in front of everybody.
But it doesn't help when they get support. You know what I'm saying? You got support from every black newscaster the whole day
Shannon
through.
Shannon Sharp.
And then when they gave him the 16 to do, all of a sudden, like, okay, that's too far. Like, nah, it's one of those things where it's like, just shut up about it.
You yeah, know what I'm like, saying? Why you got to give your opinion? Like, if I was a basketball player and they asked me how I felt about the Kyrie shit, I'd be like, shit, I don't know nothing about it. Next question.
Good or bad?
Yeah.
Good or bad, just stay out of it.
Me and Jasmine was just having this conversation earlier in the week, and it was kind of hard for her to feel me on it, but I was saying, like, look, if you depend on the money from these motherfuckers, don't go up there and say shit. I don't care what it is. If it ain't about basketball, don't talk to me about it. You know what I'm saying? I'll talk to whoever, like, you know what I'm saying, a different podcast
right. Or
somebody asks me a question or something. You know who probably ain't say shit about it?
Kawhi Leonard. Kawhi Leonard's probably like, I don't give a fuck.
Exactly. But my thing is, I'm just saying, if you solely depend on the money from an organization as big as the Nets, you shouldn't be saying nothing against any of their policies whatsoever. I don't care what
Kyrie?
It is. Yes. Because, I mean, you kind of brought some of this shit on yourself.
And I think that's what
I get what you're saying.
And that's what, yeah. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying the people, whether they agree with what Kyrie did, whether Shaq agreed with what Kyrie did or didn't, I don't think it helps for him to speak on it. Like, don't speak on it. Yeah. Like, that's between, honestly, because it turns into a damn, that's fucked up. Why they doing him like that, these 16s? So now it's a us versus them, but y'all already chose their side.
True.
So now it ain't nobody to back
Shannon
Kyrie.
Shannon Sharp had to go back and say that. And he was one of the first people to kind of condemn Kyrie.
But he went back and said, like, yo, that's fucked up how they doing him. Like,
yeah.
Like how they trying to make him beg for his job back.
Right, but and now it's like you contradicting yourself because you were saying what he did was wrong
it's
already.
They
but
already got your support.
I say the worst one was Jalen Rose. But, I mean, either way it go, you know what I'm saying? It's sad that we got to see things like this.
Right.
Definitely when it's a topic like this you know what I'm saying, it's some validity in what he's saying, and it's like people just choosing to overlook that.
I mean, yeah.
And just condemn
And I
him.
Would say, like, I was thinking, like, Kanye kind of proven, they kind of proven Kanye's point at this point.
Yeah.
About how they control everything. And I don't want to, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah. I mean, nah, they are
But, yeah,
point.
Like, they proven what he's saying. Like, look at all the power they got.
Yeah. And they have a lot of power. A lot of influence.
That's like I told you last week, though. Until you niggas sit down and come up with a list of things that offends you and put that shit out there and come up with your own defamation league and this, that, and the third, and you too can have the same power. You got to organize if you want. If you want what they got, you got to organize.
How do we start?
Shit, man. We need a leader, bro.
Did you
How
vote?
How do we start?
Did you vote?
How do we start?
I'm just asking, did you vote?
We need Dr. Umar. Dr. Umar going to be on Breakfast Club next week.
Oh,
you know you're about to shut shit down.
I can't
oh
wait.
Goodness.
Me either. I can't. I'm going to watch that shit early in the morning.
Johnny going to be sitting in front of the TV.
You All know right. it. My boy.
Johnny, we need your week 11 picks.
All right. Shit.
Oh, no, dog.
Tweet-a-boo, tweet-a-boo, tweet. Y'all go. Tweet-a-boo, tweet-a-boo, tweet.
Week 11 picks, Tyrone.
Tweet-a-boo, tweet.
Come on, be my bitch.
Tweet-a-boo, tweet-a-boo, tweet. Come on, be my baby tonight.
Mama,
come on, be my baby. I've seen the way
How
you treated other thugs you've been with. Come on, be my
He's
baby tonight.
Enter takeoff.
All right, here we go, y'all. All right, week 11. That's what we on, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, Titans at the Packers. Give me the Titans.
Yeah.
Bears at the Falcons. I'll take the Bears.
George, stop cheating. You got to pick everything opposite.
Hey, Eagles at the Colts. I'll take the Eagles.
Eagles.
Jets at the Patriots. I want to take the Jets.
They that good this year?
Commanders at the Texans. I'm going to take the Commanders.
Commanders.
Rams at the Saints. I'm going to take the Rams. Browns at the Bills. Give me the Bills. Panthers at the Ravens. I'll take the Ravens.
Yeah.
Damn.
Lions at the Giants. I'll take the Giants. Raiders at the Broncos. I'll take the Raiders. Cowboys at the Vikings. Damn, that's going to be a good fucking game. Give me the Cowboys. They're the defensive line, something else, and the Vikings ain't proven. Bengals at the Steelers. I'm going to take the Bengals. Chiefs at the Chargers. I'll take the Chiefs. And 49ers at the Cardinals. I'll take the Niners.
All right, man. So everybody who listens to this, man, if you're filling out your pick 'em sheet, man, there go your picks right there for the week. Right.
Pick 'em.
Yeah. Y'all still doing pick 'em at work?
We doing fantasy this year. The barbershop is still doing pick 'em, but I ain't got the money for that. They pay it's $12 a card.
Less than an hour.
Less than an hour. Cool. All right, man. Other than that, it's time for them awards.
Anything's possible. Anything's possible.
I think that was everything. Yeah, that was everything. It was everything was politics this week. Mm. Everything was politics
Friday
this
night.
Week.
Damn, I could be able to do something when I leave here.
No. All right, man. Real nigga of the week, Johnny.
All right, man.
Myself.
Shut All right, real nigga of the week gonna go out to one of my favorite restaurants, even though they got rid of the 2 for $20.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
What is it now, 2 for $25?
I don't know what they changed it to. I gave up. Once you start cutting shit down, like Wendy's went up $1, so it's okay. But yeah, fuck you, Chili's.
Wow.
And they got rid of the spicy ribeye.
It's 4 for $5 at Wendy's now?
Wendy's is 4 for $5. They still have a 4 for $4 option, but it's just a junior cheeseburger. Hmm. Nobody wants a junior cheeseburger.
This nigga is upset.
Don't get me started, man. And then Burger King just came out with their shit.
Shit, this nigga had a whole fast food revelation.
Piss me off, man. So Pop Base on Twitter, they posted Nick Cannon is now expecting his 12th child. Just last week, it was announced he was expecting his 11th. Mm. So Chili's Bar and Grill tweeted, "Don't worry, Nick Cannon. We don't limit kids' meals."
Hey.
That's good news, man.
Yeah, you can get as many kids' meals as you want. Can I get a kid's meal?
Unfortunately for Chili's, he won't be with all 12 of them kids at once.
That's true.
We don't
Unless for Christmas, he might have Chili's catering.
You know what? He is rich. He could do that. He could pull that.
If I got 12 kids, nigga, I'm getting a kid's meal too.
Right.
If I had 12 kids,
and the youngest
nigga,
I think the only one that he may not have the twins. See, it's different. Mariah Carey got money.
I think about Nick Cannon had 12 kids, and every time I think about it, I think about this picture from this Bible story book I used to read as a kid, and Moses would be sitting and talking to the kids in the village, and they just all be sitting around, and he just be teaching them. That's how I see Nick Cannon just like teaching them. Listen, brother.
What is he teaching them?
Teaching
how to wild out.
Nick Cannon,
wild.
I can't wait to see his interview with the dude from the ADL. I feel like he gonna make some good points.
Oh, it ain't came out yet?
No, I've been searching for it all the way. I can't wait to see the interview. All right,
they
man. Dunce
little
metal.
Battles between the kids.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
So a University of Kentucky student is banned from campus for her use of racial slurs. Now, there was a video this week. There's a drunk white woman or white girl, whatever you want to call her. Looked like she was going off liquor and maybe some pills, and she just kept repeatedly calling this black girl a nigger.
Oh. Did she go in her mouth?
Over and over. No, honestly, shout out to the black girl for keeping her composure.
Oh, she kept her composure very well.
That word is losing its power with this younger generation because they're in college, so she was just
losing
kinda
its power. So I think if she just would have said it, it would have been like, all right, you racist. It video would have came out, whatever. But she was attacking
her. She was
her.
Going
trying
in.
To fight.
She was trying to fight her. And so
she
the
was
fact
like,
that that black
nigger
girl.
Bitch.
Right.
Stupid nigger bitch.
She was holding on to her
that's
wrist
that
like,
drunk
whoa.
Girl. You know, the white girl, they get drunk.
No, she was leaning like
nigger.
This.
Nigger.
Nigger bitch.
My dad owns this place, nigger.
Stupid nigger bitch.
You know, I got kicked out for being a nigger lover. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was me.
She was just going in with
niggers.
It.
Yeah.
But shout out to the girl for keeping her composure, man. She kept her composure. The girl was trying to fight her, but you know when somebody, like, don't have strength? So she was just holding her while she swung. She was like,
and she had on Crocs.
She was holding on her tongue to her wrist. She was just kind of waiting for a security
and her friend
to get
was there. Her friends were around her recording, and the other friend was just laughing like, yo, this girl, what's wrong with this
Doris
girl?
Burke should have went to the tanning salon.
Jesus Christ, you know you're white women, man. All right, man. Johnny, man. Shit. Person of the week.
All right, y'all. Person of the week this week.
Ja Morant.
I want to see if she look pale or not. Show her again.
Man, they always look pale. All
right, go ahead.
All right, NBA veteran referee Derek Richardson.
Uh-oh. All right. That nigga, that's a black man.
Yeah, he is a black man, man.
Derek
So what Derek did, he bought a private elementary school and renamed it after his mother in Inglewood, California, where he grew up.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he giving back to his community and also, you know, trying to educate the people in his community of where he came from.
That's what's up, bro.
So shout out to him, man. Veteran referee, Derek Richardson.
It's one of them referees. Oh, no.
What, the one like Gucci Mane?
Nah, it's one player from the G League, the nigga Brandon Ingram or something Ingram. He, on his free time, he tutor kids. I thought that was pretty cool.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
You still rolling? All
right. I thought that was pretty cool.
All right, man. Other than that, that has been episode 233, man. You niggas got closing remarks?
Not really.
Oh, okay.
I can still. Came in flat with the us.
Yeah, trying to think, man.
Y'all gotta work better on the spot.
I know, I gotta get ready. I gotta start having my shit ready.
niggas, stop.
Stop what?
I don't know.
We gotta come up with a plan.
We need to actually begin.
We gotta come up with an action plan.
We gotta begin some shit.
Next NAACP meeting, I'll be there.
Protect your brother. Umar. How about that?
Oh, man, they don't want Umar. Umar too militant.
That's what you need, bro.
And he say things three times. They gonna get tired of that
Yo,
shit.
Yo, I was trying to watch one of the videos. I was like, bro, if Brett don't finish his goddamn thought, goddamn.
He be like, this water right here is spring water. This water right here is spring water. Brothers and sisters, this water right here is spring water.
Do not drink the Dasani, my brother and sister.
Acidic.
Or the Deer Park. We do not drink either. Alkaline 88 only.
Somebody asked him about the school. He said, the HVAC is ready. The HVAC is ready. The HVAC is ready.
That's it. That's the only thing that's ready. That's the only program they're going to have.
You can say he got to get some security systems hooked up from a black-owned security company.
I love these dudes, yeah, you're going to have Latrell and Darnell out there.
Hell yeah.
We don't make security
hooking up
systems.
iPhones. Hooking up iPhones in the corner.
Yeah, man.
Yo, y'all niggas like stupid. That. Anyway, man. Listen, man. I don't know how you watching this right now. Shout out to you for finishing the show. If you're watching on YouTube right now, subscribe. You can listen to us every Monday. Apple Podcasts, Google Play, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, and
Audible.
Spotify.
Okay.
Yeah.
We might need to do that in the skit. Security right. For Dr. Umar.
It's a bunch of skits. It's a bunch of skits y'all could do.
We could do HVAC for Dr. Umar.
Be like, you see something, nigga? I ain't no snitch. Why you radio me, nigga? I ain't no snitch, nigga. What the fuck?
He gonna call us some beta males.
I'm signing out for D, signing out for James, I'm signing out for Jukebox Johnny. Man, listen, man, we want y'all to love the life you live and the people in it. Find the positive in every situation to live in the moment because this life is not forever. I'm Jumpman Jones. We'll talk to y'all next week.
Oh, shit.
Peace out, nigga.
Dad, are you on the radio?
Would you go in like OG style, like, give me the money!